Georgia Senate race, former football star Herschel Walker is set to face off against Senator Raphael Warnock. Many in the GOP worried about Walker's recent missteps and whether that spells trouble in a state that they desperately need to flip. CNN's Kristen Holmes has the latest.
Thank you.
In battleground Georgia, growing concerns about Herschel Walker's candidate performance amid a series of verbal stumbles. From his views on climate change.
Since we don't control the air, our good air decided to float over to China, bad air. So when China gets our good air, their bad air gotta move. So it moves over to our good air space. And now we gotta clean that back up.
To gun legislation.
Do you support new gun laws in the wake of this
Texas shooting? What I like to do is see it and everything and stuff. I like to see it being everything.
Miscues like those, plus a recent disclosure he fathered three children he had not spoken about publicly, sparking questions about Walker's ability to defeat Democratic Senator Raphael Warnock in one of the Republican Party's best opportunities to flip a Senate seat.
Georgia's Senate race this November is yet again probably going to be the deciding factor in control of the U.S. Senate. And with a volatile national environment for Democrats, Raphael Warnock defending his seat could end up being the decisive 50th seat for Democrats or Republicans.
It's Herschel Walker versus the truth.
Warnock's re-election campaign has aggressively questioned the GOP nominee's preparedness for office in several recent television ads.
Is Herschel Walker really ready to represent Georgia?
Hello there!
Walker's campaign now signaling a reset. This week, announcing the addition of several top Republican operatives, less than 2 months after the former football star easily clinched the Republican nomination, boosted by the endorsement of former President Trump.
Herschel has been one of the greatest athletes in America, and I know he will go down also as one of the greatest senators in America.
Well, hello, Atlanta, Georgia!
But Warnock is facing his own challenges.
Some of the things that we're seeing nationally, issues with inflation and gas prices and kind of the pessimism about the direction of Joe Biden as president, is trickling down into Georgia voters, even ones that are Democrats, even ones that may like Raphael Warnock. There's also this feeling that Joe Biden and Raphael Warnock are tied to the hip that Republicans are trying to push.
That's a message outside groups supporting Walker are reinforcing on TV.
Tell Senator Warnock to start voting against reckless spending to stop inflation.
A recent Quinnipiac poll shows while just 33% of Georgia voters approve of Biden's job performance, a significantly larger share, 49%, approve of the job Warnock is doing. Warnock also outpacing Walker in fundraising, hauling in more than $17 million during the second quarter of 2022, compared to roughly $6 million for his GOP rival. And Don, both Democrats and Republicans in the state have told us they believe this race really could go either way. And that's very clear from how the parties are spending in Georgia. We are still 4 months away from this election, and there's already been nearly $60 million going into ads in the state. Don?
Jeez. Kristen, thank you very much. I appreciate that. Joining me now, CNN's senior political analyst, Ron Brownstein. Ron, thank you. It's a lot of dough, right?
It is a lot of money.
Let's put up that poll again because, you know, 49% of Georgians approve of the job Warnock is doing. He's pulling in the money, more money than Walker. Recent Quinnipiac polling shows that Warnock is up 10 points.
Yeah.
There it is.
That's probably too high.
You think so?
Yeah. There's a new poll out today. AARP is doing polling in battleground states done by the pollsters in 2020 for Donald Trump and Joe Biden. So it's credible. Fabrizio on one side, Anzalone on the other. They had Warnock up three today. But most importantly, they had Warnock up three at a time when Biden's approval, as Kristen's piece pointed out, was only 34% in the state. That is remarkable. He's running 16 points ahead of where Biden is. We have seen very little of that in the last couple decades, candidates being able to levitate that far above a president in their own party. But Warnock has some real assets and Walker has some real vulnerabilities.
It's interesting because he has all these missteps. There's a gaffe after gaffe after gaffe and even straight up lies. But the interesting thing is that he appears to be getting all of the media attention even with that. Is that drowning out his opponent?
No, I think Warnock has a pretty vivid presence in Georgia. You know, look, I mean, people who run and study Senate elections talk about how over our lifetime they have become more parliamentary, meaning that voters increasingly seem to be deciding which party they want in control of the Senate and not so much on a choice between two individuals. Herschel Walker is testing the maximum extent of that, because he is, I think, there have been very few candidates who have ever raised as many doubts about their own qualifications for the job. And he's in the ball game because Georgia is a tipping point state. It's a close state. And voters, as we saw with Biden's approval rating only at about 34%, are really unhappy with the way things are going in the country. But even amid all of that, I mean, in this poll today by Fabrizio and Anzalone, Raphael Warnock is winning one quarter of the voters who say they disapprove of Joe Biden. Go back to 2018, there was no more than roughly 10 or 11% in any state of voters who disapproved of Trump who said they were going to vote for the Republican candidate, and he's winning 24% at the moment. By the way, John Fetterman is very similar to that in another poll that AARP did in Pennsylvania. So the question is, can they separate themselves from what is very real disenchantment with Biden, especially by focusing on weaknesses in their opponents?
Well, speaking of Walker's, I mean, he's still got 93% of Republican vote in Georgia. I mean, it could be a really good midterm for Republicans. Do you think that is lifting his chance?
That is his only chance.
That's his only chance.
It's very hard to imagine that there are a lot of voters looking at these two candidates and the way they comport themselves and their degree of fluency on the issues and say Walker is more personally qualified for the job than Reverend Warnock. I mean, what they are saying is that we want Mitch McConnell to be the majority leader and setting the agenda. We don't want Chuck Schumer to be the majority leader and setting the agenda. And that is the problem. You know, as I said, that is why people describe Senate elections as becoming more about the party and less about the person, more parliamentary. But there are limits to that. There are always exceptions to that. I mean, in 2012, if you remember, Claire McCaskill won in Missouri because her opponent was so unacceptable, even when it was voting very heavily against Barack Obama. So, as I say, what we are seeing at least right now in a number of these states, in Wisconsin, in Pennsylvania, in Georgia, Republicans are only winning a little over 70% of the voters who say they disapprove of Biden. Okay? That is way below what you usually see for the party out of power among voters who disapprove of the president. Can Democrats sustain that all the way through November? That's going to be the challenge. But there is now a pathway and a plausible kind of narrative that's developing that could allow Democrats to hold the Senate, even if they do relatively poorly in the House.
Dun, dun, dun. Yeah. Stay tuned.
Stay tuned.